Hello everyone, welcome to Amasopti webcast. In this video, we are going to take backup of Active Directory database using Windows Server backup feature in Windows Server 2019. In our test lab, we have a single domain Active Directory forest with two domain controllers running on Windows Server 2019. Let's click on domain controllers container under Active Directory users and computer snapping, and here you can see we have two DC, WS2K19-DC01 and WS2K19-DC02. This is another domain controller, WS2K19-DC02. And we are going to take backup of WS2K19-DC01 domain controller. We have attached a new disk to store backup on this server. Since this is a test environment, the disk size 50 GB is more than enough to store backup for this demonstration. Now the first thing which I'm going to do is let's remove shadow copy limit on the volume where we are going to store Active Directory database. For that, let's right click on our backup store with the drive letter M, go for the properties, click on shadow copies, click on setting, and here I'm going to specify no limit. Click on OK and click on OK again. In the next step, we are going to install Windows Server backup feature on a local server. Here, we need to click on Manage and select Add Roles and Features. Click on Next. Select Role-based or Feature-based installation and then click on Next. Here, we need to select our local server, which is WS2K19-DC01. Click on Next. Next again. And on select feature console, we need to select a Windows Server backup feature. Let's select Windows Server backup, click on next, click on install to start the installation. There are many third-party tools available in the market for backing up and restoring Active Directory. However, the Windows Server backup tool that comes bundled with all versions of Windows Server is just fine for this purpose. Okay, as you can see, installation has been completed successfully. Let's click on close to close this console. And now we need to click on tools and we need to select Windows Server backup. You can also run command wbadmin.msc to open this console. Let's click on local backup. As we can see, there is no backup configured or no manual backup run on this domain controller. So to take a backup of Active Directory database manually, we need to click on backup once. Here, we need to select different options and the first option is gray out because we are going for the manual backup. If you are going to schedule backup, that time you need to click over here, backup schedule. Click on next. On select backup configuration, I'm going to select custom as we are going for the system state backup. So it allows us to choose the volumes which we need to backup. Let's click on next. Now here we need to add items that we want to backup. So let's click on add items. And here I'm going to select a system state. Remember, system state backup includes the data like boot files, system files, registry, Active Directory database, syswall, and if you have certificate authority installed on your server, then certificate authority database as well. So we are going with system state. And click on OK. Now one more thing which we are going to see is let's click on advanced settings. Click on VSS settings. Here we need to select VSS full backup. Most enterprise backup applications use VSS writers to create a snapshot as a way of preventing Active Directory data from being modified while the backup is in progress. As we are not using any other third-party tool to take AD backup, that's why we need to select VSS full backup. Here you can see a description as well. Choose these options if you are not using any other product to backup applications. Let's click on OK. Click on next. Now it is asking us that where you want to store your backup, on a local drive or on a remote share folder. Already I mentioned that we have attached one hard disk to the server where we want to store our backup. So we are going with local drives and click on next. Here we need to select the partition where we want to store a backup, and as you can see, the by default selected backup store M because we have only two partition on our server. One is C drive and the second one is drive letter M. Let's click on next. Now To start a backup process, we simply need to click on this backup button. We need to wait for a few minutes as this process will take some time to complete depending upon the size of data which you have on your server. As you can see, backup has been completed successfully. Let's click on close button to close this console. And here you can see one message is there that the timestamp is there. Message is there backup and description mentioned it is successful. So this is the way how we can take system state backup of Active Directory database in Windows Server 2019 Active Directory. In the next video, we will see the steps to perform authoritative restore of Active Directory database. That's it for this video. Thank you all for watching this video.